Lève bien la fille, lève bien la fille. Talk to God right now. That the word that is coming forth will meet a fertile ground. Even if there's anything in you that will choke the word of God, ask God for mercy and forgiveness. That as you hear the word will impact your life, will impact your circumstances. That you will not leave this place the way you came. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Talk to God as I invite the man of God. That God is going to use this morning. Put your hands together. For Pastor Daniel, put your hands together. I say, put your hands together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
your presence. Let your power manifest. If this is your presence, let your power manifest. In the name of Jesus, that the name of Jesus Christ will be glorified. Because this is the gathering of the sons of salvation. Let it manifest in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. You may have your seat. I said, shake the devil. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Last week, I started a message, but I didn't finish. Thank God for Papa for giving me the opportunity to finish it today. Those of you who have been looking at time, please bear with me. I'll finish for you. Hallelujah. The title was, who remember the title? Hallelujah. Either releasing the power inside of you or waking up the giant within you. Somebody may ask, do I have a giant within me? But I've got to tell you, there is power. God has blessed the power inside of you that makes you more than a giant. Hallelujah. Amen. This morning I was ministering the same word to me. And God referred me to David. He said, giant fight giants. But why did David fight the giant and defeated him? Because God made him more than the giant. Amen. Somebody shout amen. Amen. When you are in God, you are more than the giant. Amen. He said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Amen. Hallelujah. I said Solomon's crown was stolen by Adonijah, but the matter stood up. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Anybody, I said anybody who has taken your throne, you will take it back by force. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Anyone who has stolen your crown, you will take it by force. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. As your hair is growing, you are taking back your glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Your lost power will be fully restored back to you. Hallelujah. Amen. And I said, there are certain things that you have to release in order to release the power within you. Or there are certain things you have to do in order to release that giant within you to operate against the world. Hallelujah. Amen. Jesus said, I have overcome the world. Hallelujah. But somebody asked, but why is the devil always bombarding us? You know, the devil, he doesn't want to realize or accept defeat. The devil doesn't want to accept defeat. So he wants you to feel like you are defeated. But you are not defeated. Hallelujah. Now, I said, some of the things that you have to release in order to release the power within you is one. Your destiny fulfillment is of your divine assignment. Your success is tied to your divine assignment. Hallelujah. Your success is connected with your divine assignment. Ask yourself, what is your divine assignment among the brethren? Where have God placed you to fulfill your destiny? Second, I said, it is your discovery. You have to discover. Hallelujah. It is not your decision. The decision is taken by God. But you have to do what? Discover the decision of God concerning your assignment. Hallelujah. And I said, your talent is a pointer to your divine assignment. What is your talent? One day God will ask you, he gave you a talent. What profit did you make out of it? Your talent, or you are talented
and gifted. And I said, you are unique. Where God has blessed you, you alone can perform. Nobody is going to perform. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There is no one like you. You are special.
Amen.
That's why you have to look at yourself. I am special.
Amen.
You are unique. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are extremely valuable. Don't let anybody tell you are not valuable. Don't let anybody speak you down or talk you down.
Amen.
You are needed by someone. No matter who you are, even if you are poor, God has given you something to help somebody. Hallelujah. Look at the servant of Paul. Without the servant of Paul, Paul would not have met somebody. Hallelujah. You are sent to people to make their life better. You are not sent to everyone. People of God, did you hear what I said? You are not sent to everyone. Last Wednesday, Pastor said, it is not everyone that even you have to help. Because you are not sent to what? Everyone. Doctors, nurses, and those in the medical field are solutions to those who are experiencing health challenges. Teachers are solutions to those who need education. Domestic assistants are employed to help people who are too busy to take care of their homes. No matter your area of interest, someone needs what you have. The more competent you are in meeting those needs, the more valuable you become. And your reward is tied to your value. I say again, your reward is tied to your value. Your reward is connected to your what? Your value. So when you are doing something, do it as if you are doing it unto the Lord. Let it look perfect because your value is connected to your performance. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are not sent to will, not value. Peter was sent to the Jews. Paul was sent to the Gentiles. What talent do you possess? Are you sitting on that talent? Some of you can be ushers. Some of you can speak better than I do. Some of you can reach out and pull souls to the ministry. But you are sitting on it. God is going to ask you one day. That is connected to your divine assignment. Your assignment, number four, your assignment will attract haters and opposition. In fulfilling your assignment, it will attract opposition. How many times people have been talking evil about Papa? Even when he is doing good. Hallelujah. My wife is an example. People will talk evil about you, but you have to stop doing good. No. I was listening to a man of God. He said, you see, insects attract light. Not because they love light, but because they want to quench the light. Why? Because they can fly in darkness. So when the light comes, they want to quench the light. Yes, people will hate you because they want to quench the light of God inside of you. They want to quench the gift of God inside of you. They want to quench the talent God has placed inside of you. The bigger your assignment, the greater your opposition. Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 19, for a greater door, an effectual, is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. The interesting part is that The primary attackers of your destiny are people from your own household. From this household, let me come back home. You'll be hated. We are all brothers and sisters. In the Lord, we are closer than even we are closer to our blood brothers. So don't be surprised when people are hating you when you are doing the things of God in the house of God. But let them know your blessing will come while they are still hating you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The life of Joseph is an example. Absalom rebelled against the father David and sought to kill him. But for the intervention of God, God will intervene on your behalf. Hallelujah. Number five, your calling has a location. And God will change your location per time. Your present placement is not a mistake. Your present placement, it could be your job. It's not a mistake. Maybe Paul, when he was looking for the lost donkey, he thought he was doing something. Oh, hey, let's go home. It's time, you know, let's go. We have tried. Hallelujah. But it was in the search of that donkey that he met the one who anointed him into his destiny. Hallelujah. Number six, your assignment is in phases. Your assignment is in phases. There is a discovery phase, a training phase, an execution phase. Sister Pat put something, somebody put something on the WhatsApp page, and Sister Pat was explaining the trials time and the fulfillment. There's a time for trial and there's a time for exoneration. Joseph, God revealed his destiny to him, but he had to go through trial. But in the end, God created a situation that exonerated him. God will exonerate you. God will exonerate you. Do you think that there was no wise man in Egypt that could have answered that question? There was. But you know what? That moment, God took that wisdom from them. There were magicians that could have answered. There were astrologers and everything. But God took the ability from them because it was time for Joseph to be lifted. Hallelujah. It is your time. Those who are in places to overshadow you, God will bring them down. You will overshadow them. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Those of you whom your enemies are contending with you, you will trample upon them. Hallelujah. Your assignment, number seven, will require seasons of waiting. That is where the painful thing is. Believers, we find it difficult to wait. The Bible says, wait, and I say wait upon me. Hallelujah. That is what God says. Some phases are rapid, others are slow. So you must learn to be patient. There will be times when nothing seems to make sense and things don't add up. Hallelujah. Amen. There was a time nothing was adding up for me. My own experience. Because God has given me dreams and visions, but I
knew I'll go through hard times in order to walk in the arena of sources. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. The challenge, however, is to know when the enemy is causing a delay or when God's agenda is in season of waiting. Papa said, when you have done everything and still 2 years, 3 years, things are going, you have to know that there is a demon behind whatever is going on. You have to rise up. In your waiting, don't sit down. In your waiting, you have to exercise your authority. You have to exercise your authority and take action against every circumstance. Hallelujah. Last Friday, Papa said, it's not only prayer. Sometimes you need to take action. Hallelujah. Number eight, you need to train. You need training to fulfill your assignment. And I'll give you an example, Moses. Moses, God had an assignment for Moses. Now, the mother dropping Moses in the river wasn't a mistake. It was an orchestration of God so that he would be trained. Where you are right now, you have been trained for greater height. Hallelujah. Don't say that it's a mistake. Sometimes you might think it's a mistake. Some of us were doing a very good job back home, very good company. Lever Brothers, I would have my own car. I had a driver, but I decided to move here. I had a driver that was picking me every morning. When I close, I leave the office by 7, the driver will wait on me and bring me home. Then I have a messenger who will go and buy me food in the afternoon. Hallelujah. But I left. Sometimes I think I made a mistake. But it comes to God saying, your location is not a mistake. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. God has used power to bring me back to where God wanted me to be. Hallelujah. Number 9. Okay, let me continue from number 8. Training converts your talent to skills. You have the talent, but training will convert it to what? Skills. People will hire you for your skills. Hallelujah. If you have a talent and you have not mastered it, nobody will hire you. Number 9 now. Your assignment requires different people. Teachers, governors, mentors, helpers, financiers, and even enemies who will force you to stay on course. And in prayers, hallelujah. Those who reject teachers remain in darkness. Last week I said, if you refuse to accept advice, you are sitting on a time bomb. If you refuse to accept godly counseling, godly advice, you are sitting on a time bomb. And soon, and soon, and soon, it will explode. So don't refuse godly advice and counseling. Hallelujah. Your assignment requires massive investment. Your being, your time, your resources, and all. The more of this you invest, the greater your sources. Hallelujah. Everyone is destined by God to be great. Papa said it when he was talking about the what? The eagle. And then he said, you are what? Created to be what? Great. You are not created to be a mediocre. You are created to be great. Because I am created
greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. I walk upon my enemies. I override them. In the name of Jesus. What you speak is what you get. Hallelujah. You must be focused. Never stray from your goals of completing your divine assignment. When you discover your divine assignment, focus. Let me tell you, the enemies will come to derail you. Hallelujah. My next time when Papa gave me opportunity, my next message will be a derailed destiny. Hallelujah. Amen. You need God to fulfill your divine assignment. You need God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Last but two, you need patience, as I've said already. Keep your confidence. Keep your confidence. The Bible says, cast not away your confidence. Cast not away your confidence. Let them talk you down, but know whom you have trusted. Know whom you have trusted. Not the one who has brought you to this place. If it is God, I will make it. No matter what, I will make it. I don't know how he's going to do it, but he will do it. Amen. Pastor said, the very day you say how, you have faith. Praise God anyhow. Praise God anyhow. Praise God anyhow. Praise God anyhow. Even if I am down, I will praise God. For he will lift me up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Love God and love people. If you love me, you will forgive me.
Amen.
If you love me, you will forgive me. This morning, Papa asked us to open Romans chapter 8. 12. Go and read from the 17 right to the 21. There is a lot in there for you. If you love as children of God, let's forgive. What is the essence of love if we cannot forgive? In fulfilling your assignment, you need people. You must love people. No matter who he is, he may be an unbeliever. Your love may change him. Hallelujah. Brother Mike said something, his neighbor, who was somehow, but I tell you, the very day Brother Mike stepped into the yard, I believe something spoke to the man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Something will speak to your enemies.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You cannot serve people if you don't love them. You see, people you are called to serve may not appreciate you or your effort at first, but love will keep you going. This was what made Jesus very effective with people. He was driven by love to save humanity. Selfish leaders will steal from the people instead of serving them. Ask the Lord daily to fill your heart with love for the people you serve. If you hate me today, I want to ask you, love me. If you hate the man of God, let me tell you something, maybe you don't know. You are not hating the man of God. You are hating the anointing that is operating in him. That is the spirit of God in him. You say, why? When Ananias
And Sapphira thought they have lied to Peter and the rest. What did they say? You did not lie to me. But you have lied to who? The Holy Spirit. I want to repeat here again. If you don't know the anointing on the man of God, keep your mouth shut. Don't say evil about the man of God. If the man of God is demonstrating powers, healing and healing, don't say, oh, this man is that. Please desist from that. Some of us are going through things because of what we have used our mouth to say. Hallelujah. Lastly, you will succeed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God is on your side. No one can stop you. No one can destroy you. The anointing that preserved Joseph, the anointing that preserved Mordecai, the anointing that held the mouth of the lions in the den, that same anointing. Hallelujah. That took him, David, Joseph, to the throne in a country where he did not belong. It's coming upon you today.
Amen.
Right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Father God, this is the message you gave me to deliver to your people. Add your blessings to it. Let each and every one, oh God, eyes be open to the divine assignment that will cause them to fulfill their divine destinies. Father, I thank you for the power that backs your word. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Papa, thank you.
Shout hallelujah.
I
hope you took some notes. The problem we have is that we don't take notes so that we get ourselves reminded of the word of God. Something strikes when the man of God was speaking. Sometimes you go through stuff, you don't understand why. You ask yourself, why? It doesn't even make sense. Like he said, it doesn't add up. You look around, you're like, to the best of your ability, you have done all. You have done all you could do for God. And yet there are some stars you go through that you don't understand. It doesn't add up. You begin to wonder, where is God? I come to tell you, I'm not alone.
Amen.
People in the time past went through similar situations. What they went through did not make sense. Mm. Children of God that went all out to do the work of God. Look at the three Hebrew children. They went out to serve God. Mm. And all they could get was to be thrown into the pot of boiling. Look at Daniel. Mm. That's all he did for God. Well, all he could get was to be thrown into the dead. Mm. Look at Joseph. He didn't go out to sin against God because he didn't want to. He didn't sin against God.
Yes.
The reward he got was to be thrown into the dungeon.
Amen.
And I'm sure in his situation, their situation, they ask, where is God?
Yes.
But you know, the one thing is this. God did not leave them in the dungeon.
Yes. Amen.
God did not leave them in the pit.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
God did not leave them in the pot of boiling water. When there seems to be no way,
you
will make a way. When you think all hope is lost, God will show up.
Hallelujah.
That's why we call him the God of the 11th hour.
Yes.
Because he would not allow his name to be reproached because of you.
Yes.
Keep on keeping on.
Yes.
That's why the Bible says, after you have done all, wait and see the salvation of the Lord. That God that delivered Peter,
yes.
He was almost the 12th o'clock hour to be killed.
Yes.
The Bible says God sent his angel to rescue him.
Amen.
That God that brought Joseph from the pit is rising up for something.
Amen.
Oh, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said, that God is rising up for somebody.
Amen.
He would not be long.
Yes.
Do not give up.
Yes.
Don't let go.
Amen.
He will prove himself a mighty God.
Hallelujah.
I always tell God, you are a God of precedent.
Mm.
If you did it before,
you will
do it again.
Yes.
Because the Bible says he is unchanging.
Yes.
He said, I change not.
Yes.
As he was yesterday, so he is today,
amen,
so he will be tomorrow. I always pray for you, will not change because of me. Because nothing that I go through, nothing I have done can change you.
Yes.
You will forever remain God.
Amen.
And he will do it again.
Amen.
Oh, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I feel anxiety,
yes,
that I know the God that I serve.
Yes.
Sometimes situations come and feel depressed and downcast. I ask so many questions. As a human being, because I am not God, I'm a human. I feel down. And I wonder, why would God forsake me? It's like God has forsaken me. But believe you me, God can never forsake
me.
Though you may go through stuff right now, that God is raising you up.
Amen.
Oh, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All me believe. And you'll see the salvation of the Lord. Be on your feet. This week we are going into fasting.
Yes.
I want you to be energized, be expectant. We're going to start tomorrow.
Yes.
We meet here at 11 p.m. to pray.
Yes.
And on Wednesday we meet 7 p.m. to pray.
Yes.
I want you to observe your fast. You can do 6 a.m. or whatever to 6 p.m. Please fast.
Yes.
And please join the prayer.
Yes.
If you cannot make it on Monday, come on Wednesday. You can't make it Wednesday, make sure you do this Friday. The days are evil.
Yes.
It is time to watch and pray.
Yes.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, O God, for your word. I bless you.
Yes.
And I bless the man of God you have used. Father, visit his home,
amen,
in a mighty way.
Yes.
Visit them with the right of power.
Yes.
Prove your unction upon his life,
yes,
that the enemies that are waiting their mocking may see the power of God. And that they may know that you call him.
Yes.
Thank you, oh God, for your children. As we enter into a new week,
yes,
this is not a week of weeping.
Yes.
It's a week of rejoicing.
Yes.
A week of testimony.
Yes.
A week of breakthrough.
Yes.
A week of manifestation of the power of God.
Yes.
So it shall be in Jesus' name.
Yes.
As we're about to wait on you, oh God, empower us.
Yes.
Break the church that put us in captivity.
Yes.
And put the enemies to perpetual shame.
Amen.
Thank you for being God.
Yes.
We worship and we bless you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And so may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit.